is students of class 10th. Today we will take the poem Amanda. As you know, Amanda is a girl and the poet of this poem is Robin Klein. Every child feels that he or she is controlled and instructed not to do one thing or another. As you are students, you have seen at home that your parents always instructed you. You too may feel that your freedom is curtailed, short, that you are not free at home. Write down some of the things you want to do, but your parents or elder do not allow you to. You have to write some points, what do you want to do, or your parents or elders do not allow you to do. To read the poem aloud from pairs, each reading alternate stanzas, you are in for a surprise. Now I am telling you what is the central idea of the poem. The poem very effectively depicts the dilemma of a teenager. Dilemma, whether he should do that or not. Duvida, when he or she feels that his or her freedom is curtailed, parents sometimes instruct the children to do or not to do a certain thing, but the children think it to be an intrusion on their privacy. So students, there are so many instructions in the poem, as don't bite your nails, Amanda. Who is saying this? It may be her governess or her mother or her elders. Don't haunt your shoulders. Amanda is asking not to bite her nails and dash shoulders, haunt shoulders. Now Amanda's mother asking Amanda to stop and sit up straight, slouching. Amanda's mother was pleased with Amanda for biting her nails. True or false? False. Find the same meaning of the drooping, slouching. Now see second stanza. There is a languid emerald sea where the sole inhabitant is me, a mermaid drifting the blissfully. Did you finish your homework? And now her mother asks her whether she has completed her work. Did you tidy your room? Tidy? Clean your room? I told you to clean your shoes. And her mother or governess also asked her whether she had cleaned the shoes or not. I am an orphan roaming the street. Now Amanda is thinking, what came into her mind? I am an orphan. It may be that I would be an orphan roaming the street. What did she does at that time? She would roaming, walking aimlessly here and there. I patterns of dust with hushed bare feet, and there she would walk with bare feet. The silence is gold, the freedom is sweet. Now she said that freedom is very important for her. Don't eat your chocolate, Amanda. Remember your acne, Amanda. Will you please look at me when I am speaking to you, Amanda? Once again, the speaker tells Amanda not to eat chocolate, as it would add to her acne problem, pimples problem. Now, I am Rapunzel. I have not a care. Life in a tower is tranquil and rare. I will certainly never let down my bright hair. However, Amanda pays no attention to this advice. She dreams of herself as Rapunzel, who lived in a quiet tower without any care. Stop that sulking at once, Amanda. Now, the speaker loses her patience. She tells Amanda to stop her sulking. She further comments that Amanda is very moody. People would think that she always is called Amanda. So, students, I think able to understand this poem. This poem based on child psychology. Children live in a world of dream. In this poem, we have a conversation. There is a conversation between a little girl Amanda and her mother, or it may be her governess. The mother is scolding the girl again and again because she did something, but Amanda is lost in her world. For her, freedom is more important than any other thing. So, students, I think you are able to understand this poem. Thank you, students.